AC EMF applied across the inductor is equals to E naught sine omega t. This is called what to say, first equation. Now, whenever the inductor is applied to AC source, E is equals to E naught sine omega t. Now, this is the AC current. Is passing through the inductor like this. Now, whenever the AC current is passing through the coil, AC current, there is a change in current. AC current means the magnitude of the current is changed. As the magnitude of the current is changed, there are variable magnetic fields in the coil. There are variable magnetic fields in the coil. Due to that one also, there is a induced EMF. That induced EMF in the coil is represented by L into, what to say, di by dt. Right? Because of AC EMF, right, induced EMF produced in the coil is equals to minus L into di by dt, right? Now, whenever AC current is passing through the coil, AC current means variable current is passing through the coil. Variable current is passing through the coil, variable magnetic field is produced within the coil. Whenever the variable magnetic field is produced within the coil, then that leads to the production of induced EMF. Now, in this coil, the induced EMF is represented by minus L into di by dt. Whatever the induced EMF produced in the coil, it is opposite to the original EMF. That's why we are putting the minus. What is I? What is L? That is inductance. Self-inductance of the coil L, di by dt, the rate of change of current. Next one. According to the Kirchhoff law, I want to apply the Kirchhoff law. What is the statement of Kirchhoff law? The algebraic sum of potential differences in the circuit equals to zero. Therefore, in the closed circuit, the algebraic sum of potential differences is equals to zero. Therefore, the potential difference across the source, the potential difference across the inductor, the total is equals to zero. Therefore, algebra in the closed circuit, according to the Kirchhoff law, algebraic sum of potential difference is equals to zero. That means, what is the potential difference across the EMF? E. What is the potential difference across the inductor? Minus L into di by dt. Right? What is the total? Total is equals to zero. Now, in a simple calculation, E is equals to, what to say, L into di by dt, right? On cross multiplication, E into dt is equals to L into di. Therefore, L into di is equals to E into, what to say, dt. Now, di is equals to E by L into, what to say, E by L into dt. Now, here in this case, di is equals to, what is E value? E value is equals to E naught sine omega t. Now E value is equals to E naught sin omega t by L into what to say dt. On integrating both sides, right, on integrating both sides, on integrating both sides, right, what is the statement? D into I is equals to, right, E naught sin omega t by L into what to say dt. Integrating on both sides, integrating on both sides. Now integration of di is equals to I. Therefore E naught by L is constant. It is keeping out integration of sin omega t dt. Right, already we know that. E naught by L. Integration of sin omega t. Integration of sin omega t. What to say? Cos omega t. Once again, omega t is there. Right? Therefore, differentiation omega. Integration of sin. That means minus. Therefore, now, this may be written as I is equals to I naught by omega L into minus cos omega t. Right? This may be written as, according to the trigonometric functions, right, sin, right, omega t minus pi by 2. Right? Sin omega t minus pi by 2 can be written as like this. Right, now sin omega t minus pi by 2, that means what to say? Sin omega t, right, minus pi by 2. This may be written as sin, right, sin minus, I am taking common, right, pi by 2 minus omega t. Right, sin of minus theta, minus sin omega t pi by 2 minus omega t. Therefore, minus sin 90 minus theta. Sin 90 minus theta is equals to cos omega t. Therefore, now minus cos omega t is written as sin omega t minus pi by 2. Now, here in this case, on comparing, that is I is equals to, on comparing I is equals to, what to say? I naught sin, that is omega t minus pi by 2. Therefore, here this is, what to say, current expression. What is the EMF expression? If this much of EMF is applied in the inductor, the current expression is like this. Here, what is I naught? Where I naught is equals to, where I naught is equals to E naught by what to say omega L. E naught by omega L. Therefore, maximum current is equals to maximum EMF by omega into L. What is omega? Omega is angular frequency, L is inductance or self-inductance. Now compare these two equations. That is, what is the EMF? E is equals to E naught sin omega t. Right? Next, I is equals to, what to say? I naught sin omega t minus pi. Here, instantaneous EMF, instantaneous current. Maximum EMF, maximum current. What is the phase? Omega t. What is the phase? Omega t minus pi by 2. Therefore, current is lagging EMF by pi by 2. Pi by 2 is nothing but 90 degrees. Therefore, the current is lagging the EMF by 90 degrees. What is the graphical representation? The graphical representation is like this. The graphical representation is like this. What is the EMF? This is called EMF, and this is called, what to say, time. Now this is like this, EMF, right? EMF sine function is there. This is the sine function. This is the sine function. Now this is called zero. Now this is called, what to say, T by 4. Now this is called, what to say, that is T by 2. Now this is the 3T by 4. And this is, what to say, 3T by 4. Next, this is called T. Now at the T by 4, what is the maximum EMF? E naught. At the 3T by 4, what is the maximum EMF? Minus E naught. Now this is called current derivation, EMF equation, right? What is the current? What is the current? Current involves sine omega t minus pi by 2. Sine omega t minus pi by 2 as the current, right? Now this is coming like this. Now this is coming like this, right? Now this is coming like this, right? Now, therefore, E versus T graph is like this. Now, current versus time graph is like this. That E is equals to zero, right? There is a maximum value of the current. Therefore, E versus T is like this graph. And I versus T graph is like this. From this graph, right? From this graph, the current is lagging by EMF I. Is lag by 90 degrees with respect to, that is EMF. Therefore, now EMF is in the forward direction, that in the back, that is the current is there. The current is lagging EMF. The current is lagging EMF by 90 degrees. Therefore, this is the phase diagram related to the EMF and the current.